Hello, hi, hola, ¿cómo está? I don't know how to start a video. Hi, welcome to my first video since probably 2017. Today's video.
Hello, editor-in-chief, director, Kato here. Just wanted to say that Avo forgot to introduce themselves. Their pronouns are they, them, theirs, yell.
But I've just been wanting to make videos because I have so many ideas and it's a creative outlet I've always wanted to explore more for myself. And I'm in isolation right now, so why not? The other day I was watching a video. It's actually the only video I've watched by this creator. But it made me subscribe and I am excited to dive into their videos more. But yeah, so this video is influenced by Executive Ostrich. They made a video on Iceberg of Webkinz and it was super interesting, super well done. And when they mentioned Kinztunes, I like had instant flashbacks and I was like, oh my gosh, I want to listen to these songs again. And went on YouTube, looked them up. There's a lot more than I remember. So I decided I'm going to listen slash react to the best of Kinztunes. So I'm going to listen slash react to those as well as rate them from my favorites. There's 11 tracks, so from 1 to 11. And before that, I figured I'd do a brief Webkinz history, which I did watch a video by KKclue, which I will also link their video down here. But I am mainly focusing on the beginnings of Webkinz as their history because they are still a game that is active today and being updated today. But when I was playing was during, I guess, its original launch, which what is now called Webkinz Classic. So yeah, let's get into it. I got my little notes here because my brain's not capable of remembering all this right now. It's been a long time since I've memorized oral presentations. Webkinz was created by the company Gans, which is a Canadian company based in Toronto, and they began business in 1950. It is now ran by the third generation of the Gans family. So Webkinz basically is an MMO made for kids, and I know that the fan base still has a lot of adults playing as well today. It was one of a kind because what you did is you bought a plushie at the stores. I remember I bought mine at the Hallmark store in the mall. I'm not sure where else they were sold, probably at all kinds of stores. And they came with this like secret code, which you would then like take your code, put it online, and then the plushie you bought would be then transported virtually into the game. And that is just a very innovative way to get kids involved more into a product that some kids probably would have never cared about without the virtual aspect of it. At the beginning, pets cost a minimum of $15. And I remember a couple years ago going to a dollar store and finding a Webkinz for $5. So Webkinz was first launched April 29th, 2005. Its main focus was, and I do believe it still is, the caring and bonding with your pets because you brought them to life in a virtual way. And also building a family of pets because you could add more and more pets to your family. It was also a great way to play with friends. Although at the beginning of Webkinz, they did not have any shared spaces, but they did end up adding those later on, like the clubhouse and whatnot.
There's something in the eye.
So in all, Webkinz has released 68 animal plushies, 26 styles of Lilkins, and they have loads of accessories ranging from clothing for your pets, purses to carry your pets around in. They had figurines, charms for like charm bracelets, and I do know that at one point they also had a trading card game, which I do think they still have from seeing KKclue's video. He bought some 9 months ago, so And in all of the animals that they've released, they have 3 retired pets.
Webkinz Wiki says there's a lot more than 3 retired pets. I'm assuming I must have misread the information on the Webkinz website and that the 3 originally retired pets were the ones I mentioned next. So before continuing on with the 3 I'm about to mention, I just wanted to quickly show you guys how many are supposedly retired.
First one is Cheeky Dog, second one is Cheeky Cat, and the third one is Love. And by summer 2006, they had over 1 million users without any promotion other than word of mouth. Think about it. That's amazing. That speaks so loudly for what they had created for children and in a gaming industry and also in the plushie world. They literally had over 1 million users within a year. And according to Wired, who had published an estimated amount of, I don't remember if it was like profit or overall income. I'm not like a business person. I don't understand all that stuff very well. But they had made $100 million. So they were rocking it. And turns out that Webkinz to this day is still Gann's most popular product. So they didn't have like a specific animal that released first. They had a set, like a whole like series, I guess, of animals that released first. So they had the golden retriever, the black bear, the pig, the cow, the lion, elephant, and hippo.
Know that like the images here don't match up what I said, but I did get that info directly from Webkinz podcast, from like someone that was directly involved with the creation of Webkinz, so I don't know.
And I actually found a black bear at Value Village a couple years ago with the tag still on in the plastic. I donated it since then. I think in my head I didn't look it up because I thought Webkinz was dead, like, because that was pre-quarantine, and I recall hearing during quarantine Webkinz is still well and alive, and I was shocked. So yeah, I never looked it up, but fun fact. So to wrap it up real quick, 2011 is when they had their first TV commercial. So they launched in 2005 and only promoted basically through word of mouth and through having their products in stores until 2011. That is 6 years, and they freaking did great. In 2013, they introduced the free account, so you no longer had to purchase a plushie in real life to create an account. You could create an account, and from my understanding, you would have like a starter pet, you could call it. And then in 2019, they actually stopped making plushies altogether. Monetary-wise, it seems to have been very beneficial to them because they actually have more profit today than they've ever had. In 2019, with the cancellation of plushies, retirement of plushies, I don't know what you want to call it, they came off their Gang's e-store. Gann's. Not Gang's. Gann's. E-store. Which you could buy your pets virtually right there and then with real life money without buying it at a store. And I do believe it is cheaper. I haven't looked at the price, but from what I've seen and read, it is cheaper to this way. So yeah, some of their biggest competitions when they first launched were Neopets, Pup Penguin, RIP. RuneScape, which I've recently kind of started playing again. My computer setup needs to be changed and fixed up again, but low-key is fun. MapleStory, Roblox, and these were all free. So they needed something to really get people into it for the fact that it wasn't completely free. And I really do believe that the plushie designs had a big factor in that because the plushies were adorable. I wish I still had mine. My first one was the monkey, which I tried. Okay, I'm French, if you didn't know. My first language is French. I am an Acadian French person. Yeah, so why was I saying that? I had the monkey, and I wanted to name him Coco, but I had recently read or learned that cocoa, as in chocolate, was cocoa, but I thought it was still Coco. I don't know. Anyways, I ended up misspelling it, and I wrote Kakoa. So yeah, that was my first pet. And then eventually I got a polar bear. Do not remember what I named him, because in 2005, I was born in 96, so I was nine. So that was 16, 17 years ago. Wow. Like, I know I'm not old enough, but sometimes, like, when you think back about stuff like that and you're like, over the 15 digits remembering stuff. Like the other day I was like, yeah, that was 20 years ago. And I was just like, I can say that now. I don't know. Existential crisis. Anyways, back to Webkinz. They did have an update, which I know there was a lot of backlash about. I haven't looked up into it too much because when I stopped playing Webkinz, I was still in middle school. I do believe I was in grade 8 when I like completely stopped, but I think I was around grade 7 when I like started slowing down, which would have been like 2009 2010. So I don't know much about the new update or anything that really happened after that, minus what I've looked up quickly for the brief history. There's still updates, an active team. They actually have a podcast called Podkinz, which I did get some of the info for the history from. They still have a large player community of all ages. And like I've already mentioned, it is a free MMO now, completely free, with options of memberships that are very low prices compared to like the $15 you used to pay for an animal. Although I thought it was worth it. I just realized I didn't introduce myself. I'll do that after and edit it in the beginning. And before I end this, I just want to say some, memorable mentions of things that I remember from when I was playing. I'm sure there's other things that were implicated in the game that I enjoyed while I was playing that I just don't remember because I am 25 years old now, going on 26. Yeah, so memorable mentions. Curio shop, which I absolutely loved. You would basically go mining for gems and you would try your luck at getting the gem of the day to eventually get the crown. I've always had a special interest in stones and gems and stuff since a young age because of a childhood friend's mother. So that was super fun to have that implicated in the game. I also really enjoyed the employment office. I do believe you could do a new job every 8 hours. And I really enjoyed that. Like, it was just super fun for me. Also, there was the Wheel of WoW and the Wishing Well, which, when I think back in retrospect, really was based off casino games. Anywho, like, as I said, I was like 9 when I started playing, right? So Wheel of WoW is when I first realized that WoW is mom upside down. And that was clearly mind blowing to me because that is a memory that like I recall. I recall being in front of the computer and realizing that. So, fun fact about me. There's also the clothing outlets. There's two of them. There's the Kinstyle shop and then there's the Kinstyle outlet. Not much to explain. It was clothes and stuff and I loved dressing up my animals. Like, some of my favorite games at that time were like on Stardoll and stuff. There's also Kinstyle Academy, which I absolutely, like, that was probably one of my favorite things, honestly. With like, Kinstyle Academy was basically you would take classes and develop your skills and whatnot, and like I just loved it. It was just such a fun interactive game. There's the tournament area, which was super fun too because you had options where you could play directly against other players, or you could do like kind of like a solo tournament thing where like every player like plays alone, but then like it's all like added up against you. Anyways, super fun. I personally very much enjoyed the cooking. So you could get like a stove and stuff or like a barbecue and whatnot. And if you put certain ingredients together, you would either create a new recipe, which your pets would love, or you would create slop like on Big Brother. It was great. I loved it. Obviously, I love taking care of my pets. A big aspect of the game that I truly loved. I've always been someone that loved games where you're taking care of things, I suppose. And decorating rooms. One of the first video games I've played after Webkinz was Sims, so that says it for itself. And honestly, one of my favorite things ever was the interactive TV, which I've heard that is been buggy for like 4 years now, which sucks. But you used to be able to turn on the TV directly in your room. I hear now you can only do that in the tree clubhouse thing now. I don't know. Anyways, and they had three shows. So they had Monkey and Monkey, which was like a comedy show with a monkey and the puppets that you pretend talk by themselves, those. And it was super funny, I loved it, it was one of my favorites. And then there was the Secret Chef show, which I also loved. And then there was the third one, which was called Winner's Show. I honestly do not remember whatsoever what it was about. And that's the end of a brief history of Webkinz. I'm sorry if that wasn't very brief. Hi. It's a new day. Salem woke up from their nap yesterday and was not having it, so here we are. I don't necessarily remember where I left off, so we're just gonna get right into it. The Best of Kinztunes is an 11-track album that came out 2010, possibly 2009. You can currently buy it on iTunes for $9.99. And yeah, we're gonna react to it, and then after the end, I am going to sort it from my favorites to least favorite in the album. So let's get to it. I'm using my Switch right now to play the music off of YouTube. I will have the links to the videos in the description. All right, so track number one is Hug a Pug. It's November 2009's Pet of the Month. Let's react to it. This is a bop. I love the groovy disco vibes it's got. That was Hug a Pug, and I absolutely loved it. I'm not gonna lie. I don't remember it. I don't remember a lot of the songs, to be honest, because like I said earlier in the video, I was really young, and that was like 15 years ago for me. But this song's a freaking bop. Like, A++. So, song number two on the album is I Wanna Run, which was the Great Arabian Pet of the Month music video in August. I'm assuming also 2009. But I think they missed what they were aiming for. I can hear the like pop punk heavier vibe they're trying to go for here, but also still make it kid friendly. And I say, if you're gonna go there, go there. The voice could have been more aggressive while still being welcoming. The backtrack could have been slightly heavier as well. The music video, I actually like this one better than Hug a Pug. I find there's more variety to it, less repetitive movements, which I did enjoy much better watching. Not a terrible song, not good either. Has potential though, it could be reworked. I would love to see someone rework that song. Track number three is I Got a Lot of Soft Spots. It doesn't say here if it was like a Webkinz of the Month or anything. I've got a coat that all the girls love. They think I'm dead. All right, off the bat, love the vibe, great harmonies, fun. Let's keep watching. Okay, I love this. That was good. It was fun. It was upbeat and jazzy. The music video is very fun and funny. Off to the next. Track number 4 is called Piggy Plum Pie. And it says here, June's Pet of the Month. Of course, it's got a country song.
Life on a farm is a life for me. I'm a happy piggy with a piggy family.
Ooh, I keep doing that. Personally, I'm not a huge fan of country. I did grow up listening to country music, so there is like old country music that I do still love and enjoy. But this is catchy and fun, and the voice is pleasing, so it's a good song, especially as a song aimed towards kids. So, fun song, love it. So, track number 5 is The Prettiest Pink Pony in Town. Let's jump into it. Was not expecting a heavier song for a pretty in pink song, so this is exciting actually. Okay, I'm only like 13 seconds in, and all I've got to say, if they would have given I Wanna Run this energy, this fluency, it would have been a much better song. That's all I'm gonna say. Love it. Honestly, I have to remember these are kids' songs, and obviously they're not trying to be lyrically masterful songs. The vibe I'm getting is that it's trying to be an uplifting, positive, confidence-boosting song, which I love. I do think some of the messages didn't age well 100%, but it's not bad. It's not like saying bad messages or anything. That's kind of what I'm seeing. The music video is a little repetitive. I wish they would have had a little bit more diversity in the clips they're showing through the video, but overall, really great song. It's not my number one, I don't know. It's up there. Track number 6 is A Dog with a Bow in Her Hair. Yeah, I don't got much to say, except that the title kind of reminds me of Emma from The Wiggles, but that could also be because I'm a parent. Sorry, school obviously just went out and the kids are walking home. Anyways, so.
We're coming!
fun song, simple, soft, feel good, not like a catchy bop or anything, but I really like it. And the music video is really cute, and I like that it wasn't as repetitive, but it held my interest a lot more. And yeah, overall good song. All right, so track number 7 is Misunderstood, No Friends Blues. I love it. Like, rework this a bit to make it more mature and a finished song, and this would be in my regularly played playlist, for real. Also, I need to find out who is singing this because she has a beautiful voice. I sadly can't see the description of videos on my Switch, but if I find it out, I will either come back in here while editing or add it in the description. Music video is really cute. I like that it's about a skunk that is misunderstood and everyone is scared of the skunk because, you know, skunks can be smelly, but the skunk's very friendly and just wants friends. This might be my number one. I'll have to really think about it at the end, but this could be it, guys. This could be my number one. All right, so number 8 is 9 Lives. You really missed it there. They should have put it number 9. Which was September 2010 Pet of the Month. So, let's watch.
I would like to take a trip around the world on a sailing ship. A simple boat built just for two. We'd set sail just me and you, and we'd go around. And then when we reach our destination, start over, can't you see? You're the only one for me. And if I had none, if I had 9 lives, I would live them. I would live them all with you. How I love the library. Every now and then I look for your face among the books. And if I had none, if I had 9 lives, I would live them. I would live them all with you.
Oh, what a very sweet love song. This one also, if you know, it was reworked a little bit with more mature lyrics, but you know, same, you could still do the 9 lives concept. I would listen to it on my regular rotation for sure. Beautiful voice. Also need to figure out who the singer is. I am a very big fan of slow, folky, acoustic songs, especially ones with like raw emotions. And the music video is really cute. It's really cute and well done. So this one's also competing for number 1 spot for me, for sure. Okay, so track number 9 is Go Go Googles by Webkinz, obviously. It's the August 2010 Pet of the Month. All I gotta say is I don't know if Go Go Google is still a game on Webkinz, but that was one of my favorite games. Like, I wish I knew how many hours I played that game, because honestly, it was a lot. Let's react to the song. Okay, hopefully I'll be able to like edit this clip into this video, but I've just gotta say, so far the scenery is very much giving me oh, brain, why are you blanking right now? I'm gonna say Borderlands, but that's not it. It's one of my favorite video games.
It's BioShock, guys. The name of the game is BioShock.
I take my statement back. It is giving me PMS vibes from Degrassi, The Next Generation. I think it was like season one or two. If you have not watched Degrassi, it is a Canadian classic, like a staple of our pop culture, and I highly recommend. Anyways, back to Webkinz. Definitely tell this came out in the era of Avril Lavigne's Hey Hey You. Why am my brain not working right now? And I'm not sure why, but the song itself, the chorus, but before that, is really reminding me of the Pixies' What's My Name. I'm not sure if it's the voice or not. I'll have to like re-listen to the song. It's been a long time since I've listened to the song. I love that they've got these strong, rocky, harder songs for a lot of the girl empowerment songs they've got going on, or the feminine empowerment songs. I know that obviously had a lot to do with being the 2010s in that era. I just think it's great that they added that in a kids' environment, because they're like us. All right, so track number 10 is called Where Did You Get Those Stripes? I don't see here that it was a Webkinz of the Month or anything. Song is definitely unlocking some audio memories for me, because I remember hearing this song as I'm listening to it. It's the only one that that's happened to so far. So another fun rocky bop from Webkinz. Y'all went with it and I love it. This one's also like a really good one, not gonna lie. The video's fun, a little repetitive, definitely not enough contrast between the cat and the background where the stripes are. Besides that, fun video, fun song, catchy song, wants to make you dance along. So track number 11, the last track of the album, The Best of Kinztunes, is Tiger Tiger, and it was July 2010's Pet of the Month. I'm so disappointed. This was honestly number 11th best or whatever out of the like 30 some songs they have. I think they would have been better off keeping the album at 10 tracks. In my opinion, the only good part about this song is the voice of the pink monkey. Her voice is nice and kind of blends with the vibe of the song they're going. But besides that, oh my gosh, is it ever overstimulating? that made my heart get tight. It made me want to throw my Switch, and I just wanted to turn it off immediately. The fact that I got through a minute of that is surprising and disappointing, because the rest of the songs weren't bad, and the ones that are like just okay. That's a little sad to end the album like this. That comes to the end of our listening party / reaction to Webkinz' The Best of Kinztunes album. I'm sorry, I still can't get over that last song. I'm so disappointed. Here is my, I'm really hoping I'm able to edit an actual list onto the video. If not, this is gonna look really silly. What order is my preference? And let's just get it out of the way right now. Tiger Tiger belongs at 11. It doesn't even belong on the soundtrack. It is not nearly up to par to the rest of the album. We're gonna forget that even exists, okay? That song doesn't exist. It's not real. If we didn't hear it, it's not on the album.
The next song is not my number one. My number two is my number one, and my number one's my number two.
My number one song would have to be Misunderstood. It's the one I remember the most in my head, even though it wasn't the catchiest one. It was soft and it was fun. Well, not fun, but like, you know, it was a good song. It was bluesy, it was jazzy, it was good. Number two would be Nine Lives, because as I said, I would totally listen to that as well in a regular rotation if it was like remastered with a little bit more of a mature sound. Y'all, I ain't gonna lie. I should have been marking my favorites as I was going through, because my brain does not, it's not, I don't remember. So I'm just gonna name the ones that like I know I really enjoyed out of them, okay? Hug a Pug was honestly a great first track to start the album with, because it got you into it. You're like, okay, this isn't that bad for a kids album. Let's keep listening. I Wanna Run would probably be number 10. Like it's down there. It has potential. It's just not quite there. I Got a Lot of Soft Spots was a cute song, sweet song. Wouldn't say it was one of my favorites, but it was cute. I liked it. Piggy Plum Pie, surprisingly, would be up there for me. As someone who's not even a fan of country music, really, it was catchy, it was fun, it made you want to dance along. Yeah, so I'd say it'd be up there. Prettiest Pink Pony was also fun. Also, Avril Lavigne era, for sure. I Don't Like Your Girlfriend. That's the name of the freaking song I was trying to remember earlier. Anyways, so yeah, that one would be up there. Dog with a Bow in Her Hair, also, you know, I liked it. Very well done. Music video was really good, honestly. Probably one of my favorite music videos in it. Go Go Googles was also fun. I think they could have went a little different with, like, all the girl empowerment videos, or the feminine empowerment ones or songs or leads are all very pink and focus on that, even lyrically. So I was a little disappointed that Go Go Goggles was another pink song. But besides that, really good. Loved it. Where Did You Get Those Stripes was also really good. Also loved it. And that is my reactionary video to Webkinz' The Best of Kinztunes. I had fun filming this. I had fun reminiscing about Webkinz, going down a bit of a history. We'll see if I have fun editing this, because all I've got is my phone and iPad, and I've never really, we'll see. And I'll probably be back eventually. Don't expect a schedule from me. Don't expect reliability on weekly videos or anything like that. My plan is to just make videos when I feel like it about whatever the heck I want. So, see you next time. Stay safe. Bye. I feel like I really did that awkward. Okay.